We're going big that on is. This Minnesota Live Goes Wild edition.
Yes, we are. And we're going to start with one of the state's largest bird species at about 5 feet tall. That's how tall they are, with a wingspan of about 7 feet. We are talking about sandhill cranes.
Joining us via Zoom to talk all about these graceful birds is Nate Huck, a resident game bird specialist. Hi, Nate. Thanks for being with us.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Okay, so a wild game specialist, you're with the DNR. Tell me a little bit about your work. What exactly do you do?
Yeah, so for the most part, I particularly cover resident game birds. So turkeys, grouse, pheasants, things like that. And yeah, covering a little bit of some migratory game birds as well as things like doves and woodcock as well as sandhill cranes.
I'm confused by the phrase game birds because I think of that as something that you would hunt.
Yeah.
I know we can't hunt sandhill cranes. Will you explain a little bit more about how you're classifying game birds?
Sure. So actually in Minnesota, we can hunt sandhill cranes up in the northwest corner of the state.
Oh.
So yeah, all these species we do have a season on somewhere, at least within the state.
We're already walking away with knowledge.
I had no idea.
Out of this conversation. So good.
Do
good, good,
people
good.
Hunt cranes?
Yeah, and they're actually very tasty. So.
Oh, really?
No way! I had no idea.
Do you cook it like a chicken?
No, cook it more like steak. Yeah, they can be referred to as something like ribeye of the sky. So they have a very grain-based diet. So yeah, it can taste awful like beef.
Huh? I had no idea. Okay.
We're already walking away with facts that we weren't expecting. This is very exciting.
Nate, I also did not know that there are two different populations of cranes in Minnesota. What do you mean by that?
Yeah, so we have two populations, one that's up in the northwest that we do hunt. That's part of the mid-continent population. So those migrate down to places like Oklahoma and Texas and New Mexico for the winter. And then as you move kind of further east, although they're kind of almost touching, we have our east central population. But those are that eastern populations of sandhill cranes, they migrate down to places like Kentucky, Tennessee, Alabama, or even Florida for the winter.
Tell us a little bit about their nesting and how they're, if they are spending their time here in Minnesota, what they're doing.
Yeah, so the majority of the birds that we have within the state of Minnesota that are nesting, they wait a really long time to nest, sometimes 4, 5, 6 years old before they start nesting. And then in the meantime, as they're kind of sub-adults or they're almost like teenagers, they just kind of hang out in really large flocks. They kind of learn the ropes about how to, you know, court each other and how to breed and things like that. And then, that's kind of the gist of what they're doing. And then as we get through the summer, they do their rearing of the poults, which is what those juveniles are called. And then they'll start staging in really, really large numbers in the fall before they migrate, you know, as things freeze up in the winter.
So you just kind of alluded to the fact that as colts is what we would refer to sort of the adolescent sandhill crane. But they've got a pretty long lifespan based on everything that you just described there. If they're spending several years before they're even, doing their nesting.
Yeah, cranes are one of the longest lived birds, at least in the continental U.S., we have records of individuals that have lived to 36 or even 37 years old. One bird that was originally banded in Florida that was hit by a car in Wisconsin, yeah, it was 37 years old.
Wow.
So yeah, very long lifespan.
Well, you mentioned being hit by a car, which is awful, but are there predators that seek out cranes? I mean, because they're big. Chris just said they're 5 feet tall and their wingspan is 7 feet across.
Yeah, there are a few things that will try and eat them, especially when they're those little tiny colts. Things like coyotes and foxes will try and make an attempt at them for sure, but those parents are very, very protective. And as you can imagine, it's pretty intimidating when a bird that's 5 foot tall with a 7 foot wingspan, is approaching you. So for the most part, that would be what the predators are, though.
So we kind of already hit on some of the facts here. So they don't breed until they're four, five, 6 years old. You said the big ones are in their teenage years. We just established that they can live a long time in case, what you said, almost 38 years old. I want to talk a little bit more about their travels. And I think a lot of people, when they think of sandhill cranes, we've probably all seen these documentaries about Nebraska, when they're down in Nebraska and they're in the Platte River. What is it about that particular area of Nebraska where the sandhill cranes like to go?
Sure. That's pretty much kind of that perfect environment for them. They're able to roost on the sandbars in the river that's really, really shallow. So again, in the nighttime when they're kind of their most vulnerable, they can avoid predators the best. You can kind of see those sandbars in the background there that they're standing on, even into a couple of inches of water. And then lots and lots of agricultural fields where there's waste grain, and other insects that they can feed on during that spring migration. So we'll see massive concentrations of up to a million birds that'll stage there before they make their trip north.
This might be a silly question, but are there sandhill cranes in every state?
Interesting question. I guess there's a few states in the Northeast that have very, very few, but I think for the most part, every state has at least a few sandhill cranes that are going through each year. Yep.
Okay.
Well, Nate, this is a fun conversation. We learned some things I don't think that we knew going in. And
yeah, what's your most interesting fact? Like, what do you think is the most interesting thing about cranes before we let you go?
Yeah, I just, their ability, since they live so long, they have amazing sight fidelity. And so, If a male and a female are successful in breeding together, they'll continue to be successful year after year together. And they'll stay together in those pairs throughout the winter and into the summer. But yeah, they have if they do fail, they have a pretty high divorce rate. They'll go off and find somebody who's maybe going to help them be more successful. So I think that's pretty interesting.
Well, Nate, this was a lot of fun. Thank you for enlightening us. I learned a ton.
Yeah, it was good. Really, ribeye of the sky.
Okay, ribeye of the sky. We'll post links with more information about sandhill cranes on our site for you at MinnesotaLive.com.